Beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Brother Frank speaking to you from the International Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. We look back again to a tremendous weekend God has blessed in a very special way. God's people were gathered from all over Europe, from Africa, from the USA, from Asia, from everywhere to hear the Word of God. Then we also referred to Israel. 70 years have come and gone, and we rejoice with Israel because God's promise is being fulfilled. I will choose Israel again. Isaiah chapter 12, Isaiah chapter 14, Jeremiah chapter 36, and all the other references, even up to the New Testament, when our Lord spoke about the fig tree. When we say the fig tree and all these other things come to reality, then we should look up and know that our redemption is drawing near. And we do have the promise in God's holy word, especially in John chapter 14, our Lord said, I go to prepare the place, then I will return and take you to be where I am. And then again in Hebrews chapter 9, the last verse, our Lord and Savior came the first time to save us from our sins, and he comes the second time for those who look for him. And beloved, this is so very, very important. In Matthew chapter 25, we read, behold, the bridegroom is coming. Go ye out to meet him. Go ye out. Come out from all other things and be separate and prepared to meet the Lord. And then, of course, we have to share every time the promise for this day. Beloved, the most important thing for believers is to believe the promised word. I say it again and again. True believers believe the promises of God. Abraham, the father of faith, received the promise, and he believed the promise, and God fulfilled the promise. So we are children of promise, believing the word of promise. And we say, as our Lord, the God of Israel, fulfills his promise with his covenant people, Israel, and brings them back into the promised land, in the same way, the same God has sent his prophet. He promised to send Elijah before the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And we rejoice in the Lord that we have recognized our day, our time, and we know this is the last message before the return of Christ. We go back to June 19 and 33, when the Great Commission from the supernatural cloud was given to Brother Branham, as John the Baptist was sent to forerun the first coming of Christ. You are sent with a message that will forerun the second coming of Christ. He was called directly to preach and to teach and to bring us back to God and to the Word, to restore all things before our Lord returns. And so, by the grace of God, the Lord used our beloved brother William Branham to store in the spiritual food. A man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. And so, in the last seal, on March the 24th, 1963, when Brother Branham, by divine revelation, spoke on the seven seals, in his last 25 minutes, he said this, "And if you remember a vision a year ago, so the food was stored up in this place, and that's exactly right. The food, the revealed word, the promised word for this day, the fresh meat for the children of God." And beloved, I said it many times, by the grace of God, I was acquainted with his ministry. But today, I will show you, every sermon William Branham preached was sent to me in Germany. I've all the 1,200 sermons, and I listened to every sermon, not only once, at least twice or more times. And the same Lord, whether you believe it or not, who told William Branham to store in the food, the same Lord, I take you before God Almighty, the same Lord, with a tremendous audible voice, spoke to Brother Frank to store in the food. And the prophet said, you remember, December 3rd, 62, wait with the giving out of the food until you get the rest of the food. And then the Lord took his servant and prophet on December the 24th, 1965. And from that time, Brother Frank has traveled millions and millions of miles to share the Word of God. Not only that, but Brother Frank has also translated the sermons of William Branham into the German language, and everybody has a right to know the promised Word of God. Everybody has a right to have part in the spiritual food, the revealed and promised Word of God for this day. So, beloved, we're living very, very close to the second coming of Christ, and we're grateful to God Almighty for the opportunity that he gave me in the past years. Since 1966, I shared the promised word, the message of the hour, and told God's people all over the earth what God has done in our time, referring to the ministry of Brother Branham and the divine purpose connected to that ministry now before the second coming of Christ. One more scripture, 2 Peter chapter 1. No Bible prophecy is of any private interpretation. Beloved, this is God's time. Not to interpret, but to believe every word and leave it the way it is written, in the connection it is placed in the Holy Scriptures. So, by the grace of God, I obeyed the divine call and shared the true word of God, the message of the hour, with all the peoples of the earth. At the moment, we are reaching God's people in 172 countries. If I would tell you what is going on in the bride right now worldwide, you would be surprised. May God bless you. May He be with you. Please be part of the wise virgins and believe only the word of God. Don't be foolish, believing the many interpretations. Be wise, believe the word of God, and the Lord will prepare us, and He will finish His work and return bodily. He went up bodily, and He returns bodily, and the dead in Christ will rise bodily, and we who are in this body shall be changed, and together we shall be taken up to glory. Don't believe any interpretation. Don't be foolish. Believe the word of God and be sanctified in the word of God and be blessed with the blessings of Almighty God. In Jesus' holy name, amen.